What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the one and only, the only one, the strongest Twitch.
DJ, stop lying, bro.
What? What do you mean?
Yeah, worked out in 2 weeks.
Facts.
Your boy, DJ the Chef. And today we are talking about, you guessed it, Mut Heroes. And I'm not going to give you guys too much of an explanation of what Mut Heroes is because we've already done that on this channel right here. Right there. Click that. Well, you can't click it, but go to it. We've already done that, guys. So today what we're actually going to do is teach you how to beat these challenges. So if you don't know already, Wednesday is going to be the first day you could actually get 140 stars on all these challenges because they're going to be periodically rolling out challenges throughout the week. And Wednesday will be the first day, if you get all 5 stars, to get your free Mut Hero. Now, what does that mean? It means that if you start doing it now, by Wednesday, you will be able to select from any of the Mut Heroes and get your free card. Now, cards are available, but the one that you're going to be able to get on Wednesday is an NAT card, but nonetheless, it's still a free card that you need on your team. And since we are a no money spent channel, it is my job to give you guys what you need to go out there and get the best cards. So that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to look at the Mut Hero challenges for all those of you at work and you can't actually do it yet. Or if you're at school, and if you're at school, you shouldn't be watching this at school. You should be focusing. I need you to focus. Yeah, that stuff. We're going to look here and we're going to go to our challenges, right? All right, let's go challenges. And we're going to scroll down here into the Mut Heroes. And as you can see, I already have a check here and a check here. So what we're going to be talking about today is just the goofing goons, and I'm going to do a video for each one of these. That way you guys can pick the video that you need to watch in order to complete your challenges. So you can see we've already completed here and we got our 30 stars already. I'm going to display the times around here for each challenge so you can go to that particular time so you can actually come here and not have to waste your time trying to find out which challenge and how to complete it. So you'll see we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 challenges inside of Mut Hero. Now, the thing about these challenges, I really want you guys to pay attention, is that they're in arcade mode. Okay. When we did the gauntlet, I believe the gauntlet could have been arcade mode too. Let me go check actually. The gauntlet was actually in arcade mode as well. So this is going to play very similar to the gauntlet. So let me give you guys these tips, right? When you come in here and play this game, they have these descriptions and these make-believe stories that they want you guys to follow. I mean, you can read them. You can get into them if you want. I'm just here for the stars. So I didn't really read it. Something about your team being stuck at an airport or locked in a swimming pool. Something weird. But what we have here are 5 different challenges, and each side of these challenges, you have different things you need to accomplish, of course. So this one is don't allow 2 or more completions in 6 plays and get a user sack and get 2 or more sacks in general. So you guys already kind of know what we're going to do here. We're going to go squeeze punt block on this one. I found out that it's actually a little bit easier if you do it with squeeze in that instead of straight for this particular game mode. So a key point to this is to make sure that you're controlling your return man. And you want your return man to really give you a little bit more time so your computer players can get there and get those sacks. If you don't do well controlling your return man, they're going to eat you alive. This game mode plays differently than our regular modes, and they will pass it on you using the strategy, and you will lose. It took me a few tries to get the hang of it, but I did get the hang of it in this video, and you see that we did get our 5 stars. So use that strategy, control your return man, try to not really choose a side, but try to stay right in the middle of all the receivers and get your sacks. So the next thing we're going to do is I am the one who locks. And I think this one has something to do with being locked in a swimming pool. I don't know. So pretty much, it's the same thing here. You're going to use that squeeze punt block and you're going to get your sack, and then just make sure that you don't allow 2 or more completions. What I suggest that you do is once you get your sack, try to strip the ball. If you strip the ball and you get the ball back, just run the clock out because you're starting in the 4th quarter. You're going to run that clock out and you're going to be good to go. The opponent won't have 5 plays and you won't have to worry about 2 completions. So try to get a fumble on the first sack and you should be good for this one. Now, pro tip for this, these challenges, they give you some players that are on your team and they nerf all your defensive players for some weird reasons. Like my Marcus Lattimore was like 85 speed, and I know he's a lot faster than that. They do nerf your players. So just make sure that you check your depth chart and you go to your depth chart and you put the people in that you want in, because some of the arcade or hero style players are inside of this game mode. And if you don't want them playing for you, make sure that you check your depth chart out. Okay, so next thing we have here is called Melting with Intent. This one, you're going to want to not to allow 35 passing yards, and you want to make sure they don't have four completions and force a fumble. Same strategy for this one, guys. You're starting the fourth quarter, so try to force that fumble on that very first play, and that will take care of not allowing the 35 passing yards and the four completions. If you don't, you still can kind of play it out, but I would suggest you get the fumble on the first play and then just run the clock out after that. Okay, so for the next one, Die, Die, My Darling. Yeah. So you're going to win the game here. So this is actually the first one where you're not in the fourth quarter. So this one takes a little bit longer. You're going to win the game. Don't allow 30 passing yards and force a chance of possession. Again, same strat, guys. You're going to want to force that fumble as fast as you can using punt block squeeze, and then you're going to want to run the freaking ball out. I don't remember if you're down or up in this particular one, but just run the ball out. Don't give them the 30 passing yards. Same strat for the same thing, and you'll be good to go. Now, Dr. TikTok took a little while, only because I was screwing up. For this one, this is the first one where you're actually playing the entire game. So you're starting in the first quarter. And the tricky thing about this is you can't give up more than 80 yards. So you're starting the first quarter with 3-minute quarters, and you can't give up more than 80 yards. Passing is the key. You also have to win by 10 points and get an interception. So what I did here is I pretty much focused on getting my interception as fast as possible. I came out in a 3-4 defense and I played cover 3, and I just tried to get my interception. The defense will throw you for a loop when you first start playing because it is an arcade mode, but the offense will try to help you out, throw an interception every now and then. Throw one up every now and then, and you got to use your user skills at that point to get the pick. Now, the key here is 80 yards passing. So you have to be smart. What I did was you have to win by 10. So if I couldn't get my turnovers, I pretty much would allow the computer to either run back kickoffs, or I would allow them to run the ball for a touchdown. As long as you don't allow 80 passing yards, you're good. So if the computer is running and you're worried about them getting their 80 passing yards, just run alongside them so they get a short field, maybe stop them at the 30, and that way you don't have to really worry about them getting the 80 passing yards. You'll see in the gameplay later on that's kind of what I did, was I kind of let them run the kickoff backs if I was up and I just wanted the ball back so I could run the clock out, or I would let them run 80 for 50, 80, 60, 70, 90 yards just so they wouldn't pass the ball and I wouldn't have to worry about anything. At the end of the day, this is super easy to beat. If you have a bomb receiver, just throw it up to him. Throw it up to him. I threw it up to Torrey Hope several times and he would just come down with it on single coverage and you're good to go. It is an arcade mode, so some of the stuff is unbelievable, but that is to your benefit because you can just throw the ball up to get your wins. Now, guys, that is all the challenges. I'm going to skip into the actual gameplay, and this is gameplay from me on stream this morning playing them and getting the wins. So if you guys have any questions, please feel free to hit me up in the comments. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if you like this content, or the like button, or whatever. Come check me out on the stream on Twitch at twitchtv.d. That's not the right address. twitch.tv/DG_thechef. I'm going live periodically. Just hit the notification button so you'll know. This is your boy Gigi the Chef. It's been love. It's always love. And we out.
I also can't do what I normally do because they patched that too. Now she on my and my, she just masturbating. Got it. At least 40. Coltrane album. Got it. All right, we got one sack. We just got to get that. Wait, was that a user? Did we get the user sack? Hold on, let me check. Did we get the user? All right, we got the user. So we just need one more damn sack. We just need one more sack, guys. That's all we need, and we get 5 stars on this. Let's see if this works consistently. Let's go ahead and bring this guy down. Bring this guy down here. We got 3. There's going to be some type of crossing. We just got to hold it. Got it out. He got it out just in time, man. All right, this is our last chance. Bro, this shit is hard. Hey, this is not easy, chat. This is not easy, guys. It's not gonna be like one way to do it. Got the user. Give me the user. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get it. We done now. Now we just gotta stop these damn completions. I'm a midnight mercenary. Oh, and we got the safety. Let's go. Game blouses. First 5 stars. That's game. Super dumbass challenge. All right, so we figured it out. The pinch trick works. That works. The straight block works. Yo, definitely. You at work or something right now? Cause you was playing earlier, right? Boom, 5 motherfreaking stars. Let's go. I'm doing it because I know other people don't have money to drop $150 on a team just so they can compete in Mutt, right? So I try to create content that I feel like other people can use to just be competitive. Let's go. Stop no huddling me. What's my challenges? Got my sack already. The next thing is 2 or more completions. Bet. And then what? Score? Don't let them score in 5 plays. So we just need the ball back. All right. Let me bring my guy down. Come on. Ah, they screwed me, bro. Still got it. All right, here we go. This is the last one. They're going to hold me on this one. I knew it. Let's get this money. Another 5-star challenge. Let's get this money. Hey, my man's money man with the Eli face. Hey, chat, that is the emote. The Eli face is it's a long story. So we had this guy that used to come up into the chat, and anything I said, he would contradict. So if I was like, yeah, Randy Moss, the best receiver, he's like, he's not better than Marvin Harrison. Or if I was like, Tom Brady to go, he'd be like, hey, man, it's better. So whatever I said, he would always pick the opposite of that. And so I made that emote just for him. It's the Eli face, man. This is like, it's the Eli face, bro. The tweet has been sent. J-Dub trying to figure out how to connect his PC. He's trying to figure out how to connect his PlayStation to his PC so he can stream. I'm watching his YouTube right now. He's like, hey bro, I need some help. Alright, here we go. We gotta get that fumble. Get the fumble. Let's go. Let's go, chat. Chalk that challenge up. Those colors are from the 1970s art. Deco, period. Those colors are from the 1920s, 30s art. Deco, period. Didn't know that, man. You sound like a quite educated, cultured guy there. Thank you for blessing the chat with your knowledge, sir.
I got the world, still felt alone, and ever since been lost in the stars, missing on what heaven sent. Godly, I'm faulty, a fraud maybe. Probably was a reason that your dog hate me, but fuck that bitch like the law, baby.
So I think I figured it out. Okay. Fall. I think I figured it out. You have to make sure. Oh, you're a history teacher. Hey, wait. Shouldn't you be in school right now? You took today off to play Madden. Don't tell me you took today off to play Madden. Nah, just a personal day. That's what's up, man. I'm the same thing. I took a personal day today too, man. I do software engineering at my day job. So on personal days, people will be, wait. I'm not supposed to give up 30 yards for the entire game. It starts in third quarter. Hell yeah, this is harder than Gauntlet. That's rough. I'm not trying to score at all. How can we run this clock out for two quarters? Engineer VPNs. That's what's up, bro. That's what's up. I love software engineering, man. It's so fun. Like, being able to just code up what you want. Like, sometimes I'm on Twitch, and like when I need stuff, like I created my little sub banner here. It took me like 15 minutes. It's not the best, but I didn't have to pay for it, so there's that. I'm gonna start coding up my alerts and stuff like that, man. It's gonna be real cool. All right, chat. So in order not to give up more than 30 yards, what I'm going to do is onside kick it, because I think I don't allow 30 yards. Okay, so I'm going to just onside kick it so they start at the 40, which would give me less space for mistakes. So if they start at the 35, so if they start at the 40, they only get 10 yards. That makes it easier for me to protect my neck, as one would say. Yep. It doesn't work if they go backwards. Rolling down a slippery slope. All right, I'm going to try something different here. We're going to try to actually play defense for this one. We're going to actually try to play some defense. There we go. Let's go. Yep. Let's go. I'll take 3 yards right now. I'm going to keep blitzing my guys, too. Let's go. Girl, you shining. Oh, he got me. He got me on that. All right, chat. Here we go. If we stop him here. We'll win the challenge. Somehow, my unstoppable guy has been getting stopped. What made you get into teaching history, bro? Like, you've just been always just like a history guy? Or is it kind of something that it fell in your lap and you really enjoy it? All right, chat, here we go. Here we go. Knock it down. Let's go. chalk that challenge up. Another 5 stars. Another 5 stars in the chat. That's really cool. I'm a combat veteran. Thank you for your service, sir. What branch? Right now, cause I ain't been in love in a long time. And I told you that when we woke up. I guess it might have been the wrong time. My best pickup line is young nigga with money. I ain't playing. And I studied politics and decided that I can change the future by teaching kids. Hey, well, thank you, sir. That is a very commendable mission statement that you have there. And like I said before, really, I'm really thankful for your service. Army for 27 months deployed in Iraq. Hey chat, if you're in here, man, thank this man for his service, for serving our country, bro. If you're in here, please thank this man for being unselfish with everything that he's done. Thank him for serving our country in Iraq, and thank him for also teaching our kids and bettering their future. Definitely. Do you have USAA? Mama, I think I just met me a Madonna. 5 stars. Come on, let's go. Give me one more. Bro, I've played him, man. I have played Wig Splitter a few times, man. Oh boy. Yeah, buddy. I have played him. I need some water. Let me put the head in. Okay, so your receivers are a lot better in this game mode. Got it. Here we go. I'm just going to bomb it to Tori. That might be too far. Yep, I figured it out. Your receivers are way better in this game mode. Just throw bombs. Got it. Shouldn't have told me. Shouldn't have let me figure that out. Yo, I think after we beat this one, I'm probably going to take a small break so I can do the YouTube video. Get off me, boy. I'm going to put up how to beat the first set of challenges on the YouTube video. So I'm probably going to take a small stream break after this. I'm not sure. We'll see. But I do want to get the video up as fast as possible. If you guys haven't seen the YouTube, press exclamation mark YT in the chat for the link. If you are curious. Yo, definite. What is Wig Splitter doing, man? He has like a scrambling quarterback, right? Doesn't he like always go to the sideline? I think I've played him before, man. I'll subscribe. Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate it, man. I definitely need subs on the YouTube. Trying to get to 1,000 this year. Meta run, yeah. Yeah. I can't remember if that's the dude I played where I couldn't do anything against his run. My run game is decent. It's definitely got a lot better than it was when the game first came out. I don't know if it's his offensive line or what. I'm so happy. You guys don't understand how happy I am that they fixed the lead pass. My gosh, it's night and day. It is night and day, that patch, man. It's the O-line. Yeah, bro. Wig split is O-line, man. When I looked at it, there's nothing I could do against it. And I was like, all right, either I need to go upgrade my D-line or I need to go upgrade my O-line because playing him is annoying as hell. It's annoying, bro. Again, welcome everybody to the chat. Welcome everybody to the stream. We are knocking out all of the first set of the Mutt Heroes so we can get 5 stars so we can prepare for Wednesday. So we can get that NAT card. We going for Bobby Wagner. If you're not getting Bobby Wagner, I don't care because he is the best one available. Can you imagine Bobby Wagner with 92 hit power and Patrick Willis in the middle? Jeez. Be nice. Nah, I lie. I mean, the Jalen Ramsey card is nice too. I'm not going to lie. The Jalen Ramsey card is nice. And the Kyle Fuller card was actually nice too. There were a few nice ones. There's a few nice ones. It go Holla Berry, hallelujah. That 12-second runoff is some bull crap. All right, here we go, chat. Here we go. Tori. Yep. Trying to get it, you trick. You played them head-to-head on Weekend League. I played Wig Splitter in all three modes. I played him in head to head for sure. I think he's got the best of me in head to head. Everyone does, actually. I played him in draft. I played him in draft and smashed him because he didn't have his superpowered team. And then I played him in Weekend League as well. He's a one-trick pony for sure. Yeah, I mean, if you take away, oh my gosh. If you take away that team from him, how he's built it, he's trash. He's not really a good player. Like I said, I beat him in draft several times. That's just how I feel. Oh, shiz. I think I have a meeting to go to at 12. I took the day off, but I said I was going to go to a meeting. Yeah, I'm definitely. This is going to be after I beat this challenge. I'm going to work on the YouTube video, guys. The YouTube video is going to go up, and then I'm going to take a small break, get me some lunch, and then I'll be back again to finish off the rest of the day. I need to power up my Pat Tillman today for sure. That's what I need to do. Yabish. I definitely need to finish off my Pat Tillman today, man. I'm sick of not having my Pat Tillman all the way powered up. I just don't feel like getting 20,000 passing yards. Hell of a lot of passing yards. But the one in front of the gun lives forever. So yeah, I would say the YouTube video should be up probably around, what, maybe let's say two, maybe we could try to get it up by, on how to complete the first set of challenges, and then we'll start the second set of challenges. We'll do a YouTube video for that and so forth. Yo, he's really trying to get these 80 passing yards, and it's starting to piss me off just slightly, chat, just slightly. How do you not pick that off? You scrub. Ty Law, you are horrible. Take the passing yards away from him, son. I swear the computer turns like superhuman when it's... No way. You're the pick. Oh my effing gosh, computer. You are a whole cheater. An entire cheater, computer. Give me the pick. I don't get it, man. Oh, well. It's okay. It's all good. We'll just throw it up to Tori. We'll just throw it back up to Tori. I just gotta win by three. I just need three more points. Dominoes, somebody say dominoes. Pull up, drink, headshot, drink, stand up. Drink. Sit down. Drink. Headshot. Drink. Sit down. Drink. Stand up. Drink. Pass out. Drink. Wake up. Drink. Fade it. Drink. Fade it. Drink. Now I done grew up around some people living their life in bottles. Granddaddy had to go. All right, here we go. 5 stars. Chicago. Some people like the way it feels. Some people want to. Somebody said to me, she said, why you babysitting only 2 or 3 shots? I'ma show you how to turn it up a notch. Frank. Yo, did you get the win, bro? I'm hoping you say yes. No, damn, bro. Yeah, man, I played him before. It can be frustrating, bro. It can be real frustrating, man. Pool full of liquor, then you dive in it.